Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this project will probably be our last one of the year. Plus or minus maybe one little thing. This project is going to link together what we were doing before we left for our homes. So that big, beautiful gold swirly tree that we started before. And what we've been doing since we've been home. So the elements of art. We are going to be creating a tree today, similar type to what we had before, but it is going to be emphasizing, showing, explaining the elements of art on it. So for today's project, I've already shown you that pile of options that you can have for this project. It's going to be a collage. So you're going to be gathering little bits, cutting them out, pasting them together, making some sense so that you can represent as many of the elements of art in your tree as you can. For starters, though, all of us are going to need a tree trunk. So I'm going to have my tree trunk be white. If you want to start with a white sheet of paper and then color it later, or if you want to start with a colored sheet of paper and, have your trunk be a color, that is totally fine. For the color scheme that I have chosen, I want a white tree trunk. And also, I think it's going to be easier for you all to see what I'm doing on white. Just like we did before, I'm going to draw a horizon line on this white paper. Just so that I know where my tree starts at, so that I can get the sizing about right, you are going to be probably cutting this tree out. So don't worry about if your horizon line is beautiful or not. It is just helping us gauge size. So I'm putting that on there just so that when I draw, I know what I'm doing. Just like we did with that other tree, our beautiful gold swirly-whirly trees. I'm going to start by creating the trunk of my tree. At the base of my trunk, I'm going to also create those triangular, ziggy-zaggy line root type shapes. Again, these are the roots above ground on a tree, not below ground. For the top of my tree this time, I'm not going to be doing the swirlies. You may, if you remember how, but that's not the kind I'm going to show you today. Today I'm going to show you a classic YV tree. They're really easy, but they are also very easy to like. They're very repetitive, so it's easy to make it go on and on and on and on and on forever. Don't forget that whatever you draw on this page, you're going to be cutting out. So simple is probably better. I think I'm only going to have like maybe at max a layer of four branches going out. I don't want to go all the way to teeny, teeny, tiny branches because again, I'm going to cut it out. Right. When you start a YV tree, you need to know that you are only using the letter Y and the letter V. Some nice person probably taught you how to do this, and they would say, like, okay, make the letter Y. There's your trunk and your first two branches. And then at the end of a branch, you put the letter V. And you just keep putting the letter V to make the letter Y on the end of every branch, and you go out and out and out. And if you're just drawing a little stick tree, this is great. But we don't want a stick tree because if I did try to cut this out and I cut this line, blah, 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 I would just end up with, shreds of paper. We need to bubble it. So what you're going to be doing on your tree is creating the space where your tree is not. And I know it sounds confusing, but after I draw a couple branches, I bet you'll understand. Okay, I have my trunk, my two sides. First thing I'm going to do is Y it out. So I'm going to extend out to the left and extend out to the right. I just said that backwards, sorry. But I'm extending out to either side. That's our Y. Now we're going to take our V and put our V in the middle. So I'm going to put my V in the middle of my tree. Now, I've done these a few times, so I like making this weird curvy V, but if you just want to make a regular V, that works too. Now I've got two new trunks, and I'm going to do the same thing. Take the right side, Y it out, take the left side, Y it out. In the middle, I'm going to put a V. Go to the other side. I have my little trunk. Take the right side, Y it out, take the left side, Y it out. Put a V in the middle. I now have a big, wide, fat branched tree. I've got one, two, three, four of them. This one has touched the edge, so that's the end of that one. I think I want this one to reach the edge, and I'm going to put one more on each of those, and then that's it. Okay. Y it out, put a V in the middle. Same thing here. Y, and a V. And here, Y, and a V. Now, for the sake of this assignment, I'm going to say close off any ends of branches that don't touch the side of the page. So for me, I'm just going to connect and connect. Kind of looks like, I don't know, dolphin tail or something. I'm going to connect and connect. Okay, this is all you need to make for the tree for this project. It's not too bad. This, I'm going to cut out. Okay, so I have finished my tree here. I've cut it out. It's just like a collection of branches. It's the beginning of a tree, right? If you didn't want to have to go back through and erase all the pencil, if that bothers you, you could always just flip it over. I drew on the back of my paper. That might happen to you too if you're using like an old worksheet or something for this. You might end up with text on the back, which could be cool. But you can always erase, but essentially you just want a tree. Okay, again, this tree could be any color of your choice. Whatever you've got is beautiful. I just use white for ease of, ease. This tree is going to be glued down to a second sheet of paper. This second sheet of paper can be any color that you would like, any color you've got lying around. If you don't have a sheet of paper, by all means, use like some cardboard from like a box of cereal or whatever. You find a secondary sheet that is a different color than this because you're gonna want it. Okay. For me, I'm using orange because it's what I've got. And then I need to make for myself a horizon line, some sort of grass. So I found this yellow sheet of paper, and this is what I'm going to use for my grass. Again, grass isn't normally yellow, but I'm going to use this. I'm just going to tear it. And I think I like this side better. This I would glue down, and then this, ooh, I would glue down on top of it. This orientation of bottom of the tree, background, tree trunk should look very familiar to you. This is pretty much what we had drawn for our gold trees that we had before we left. So these things I'm going to glue down. And then this is the foundation or the base of what is going to become my Elements of Art tree. Okay, let me glue for you. While that tree sits and dries, we're going to have a little chat about the elements of art here. Already, you have used a couple, if not three, of these elements of art just by creating the tree on a background. You have used space because you put a horizon line in that picture. If you recall the worksheet from last week, I did space for you. I said that we put a horizon line in that picture, which shows us space. It shows us where we are. It shows us how close we are to the tree and how far away we can see. It shows us that we are outside and not flying around in space. So, space, you've already covered. You already have a shape. You've got that tree trunk. That tree trunk is an organic shape, and it is already taken up on your tree. And you've already, though possibly out of circumstance, I guess, have already had and thought about color as well. I have already given myself a warm color scheme for my project. I have that orange sky and that yellow grass. Both of those colors are warm. My tree trunk is white. White is a neutral. White can go in any color scheme. So I've already used shape, color, and space in my tree. All I have to worry about now is line, value, form, and texture. Luckily, I have leaves or the top half of my tree to still create. And so do you. So, this is where our collage comes in. We've already done a little cutting and gluing, but we're definitely going to do a lot more before we are done. What I suggest you do is pick a shape, whatever shape it is. Some geometric shape would be my suggestion. Whether you choose a circle, a square, a triangle, have that shape be the rest of the shapes you add to that tree. And then shape is done. You've covered geometric and you've covered organic. You have the organic tree trunk, and then you have this geometric shape to be the leaves. So shape is done. If you cut out, say, some squares, some circles out of paper, whether it's, square, round, diamond shaped, that choice is yours. Say you were to cut out this shape. This shape is now a little blank canvas, a little teeny tiny one. You can do all kinds of things to it to create something that meets these other elements. Line, super easy. You can draw on here. Maybe you want to draw something that looks like leaves, or that, or maybe it's just like some sort of, I don't know, veining or something that would be, it could be anything. It could be something that looks like a feather, or it could be the veining on a leaf, or it could be in anything, but you're just drawing lines to fill this particular circle, right? You want to make sure you're still in your color scheme. I'm still in my warm color scheme here with this red colored pencil, but I've got lines going all over this particular circle. I would cut it out. I would glue it to my tree. You might want to make two or three of these and glue them to your tree. Okay, line, shape we've got, color we've got. We got to stick to that color scheme. Let's do texture next. Texture, you could do something similar. Again, you chose that shape, right? What did we do for texture on our last project? We took a texture rubbing, right? We took something that has a texture, like this lovely piece of cardboard, or you had the bottom of your shoe before. and you put it on, rub, done. Cut this one out, get it on your tree. What if you don't want to do implied texture? What if you wanted to do real texture? You could definitely do that as well. You can find things that you can glue onto your tree. You could cut out some sort of circle from a piece of fabric. This is just burlap ribbon. Or I have this one. This again, burlap ribbon. It has an actual texture. It feels like that woven, rough, burlappy feel. Okay. I could just as easily take this and instead of doing a texture rubbing on it, I could cut out a circle from it and glue that circle of this actual textured piece of cardboard onto my tree. That would also work. You can do things with form as well. Form is just 3D objects. You can find 3D things, 3D scraps, items, whatever, at your house and glue them onto your tree. I have some buttons that are within my color scheme that I have at my house. These are 3D. They have height, they have width, they have length. So you can glue them down. You can layer them even to make them stand up pretty tall. You can find other little knickknacks that work, that are the shape that you need, that have height and width, and you can glue them to your tree. You could also make something that is 3D and attach it to your tree. So if I wanted to, I could take some sort of, you know, red, yellow, orange, brightly colored paper. I could, you know, curl it up into a little tube and put the little tubes all over my tree. And these have height and width and size, and so they would be a form that is being attached to my tree. Some of my friends out there, they know how to fold like really awesome little origami boxes. You could potentially do that. You could fold some intricate, awesome thing and attach it to your tree. And that would be a 3D form because it's going to stick up out of your paper. Now, say you find something that is just absolutely perfect and you really, really want to attach it to your tree, but it's like your mom's. She probably doesn't want you to glue that item down. She wants it, right? She wants to keep it nice. She loves it. So let's not glue those items. If you want to include an item like that, just take it, say, set it on the tree, take the picture of it along with everything else, take the picture, and then go return that lovely item to your mom or your dad or your little brother, whatever it is. Okay, don't ruin something that belongs to somebody else's by putting glue on it. We do need to be considerate of our family members. Okay, so texture, form, value. That's our last one. What I would do is find a color, cut out four or five circles that are all the same, or possibly, you know, various sizes, and color them all a separate value. Right? Or maybe you want to try doing that like value gradient that we used on our old project where you had went from dark all the way to light on the opposite side of the shape. That works too. However you're going to go about this, just make sure, double check yourself that you have something with line, with shape, with color, with value, with form, with texture, and with space all represented on your tree. Now, if you're sitting here thinking like, oh my gosh, I have to make 100 decisions and make all these little pieces and find things and go discover stuff in my house. Yeah, you do. You can do this. This is going to be more fun than you think. And you're going to be running around your home scavenging for things, looking for things, finding all these little hidden treasures and somehow figuring out how to fit them on your tree. And you've got a lot of time to do it. So maybe just for today, do this much. Make the background, make the ground, and make the tree. Glue it together. And maybe tomorrow or the next day, you can go around and have a scavenger hunt for items with your family or with your siblings. And then worry about how am I going to put this all on my tree? You have a whole week or more to do this. This is your last assignment for the quarter. So I want to see what you can come up with. I want to see how creative you can get. Take your time. Make this good. Okay. I'm going to start working on my tree here, and hopefully it will be done by the end of the video. If not, I will attach a picture at the end. But good luck. Pick a shape. Go for it. Include all of your elements. Find cool things to add in. And remember, don't ruin anybody's items. Okay? Always ask permission. If all you do is assemble it on this page and lay it out and take the picture and then put it all away again, totally fine. But be respectful of other people's things. Okay? Good luck. You know how to get a hold of me if you have questions. And I will see you soon.